IGCSE accounting, February, March 2020, paper 2, question number 1. This is the first question. First, we read the required. Always read the required first. Prepare Amira's petty cash book. So we need to prepare the petty cash book for the month January 2020 on the opposite page. Balance the petty cash book and bring down 1st February 2020. So we need to do the petty cash book. Okay, we read the question. Amira maintains a petty cash book using an impress system. The impress amount is 200. So every month they will make sure they will start the month with the $200. It's restocked on the first day of each month. On the 1st January 2020, Amira had a balance of 65 in her petty cash. So this is my balance BD, my balance opening balance. How I know this is my balance BD? Because of the date, 1st January 2020. Continue read. All payment less than 200 is made from petty cash book. So any amount that we pay less than 100, we'll pay from the petty cash. On the 1st January 2020, Amira owed 85 to Razwan, a credit supplier. It means Amira owed Razwan. So, but this one and a petty cash is have no related. We skip first. We continue read. Amira provide the following information for January 2020. On the 1st January, the petty cash impress was restored. Restored means they top up back from the bank account. How much they top up back? We need to calculate. How to calculate? First, we see your impress amount. Impress amount is 200. So every month, you need to start with the $200. But your balance BD for now is only 65. You already have a 65, but you're supposed to have 200. So how much I need to top up to make the balance 200, 200 minus 65, I'll get 135. So now I need to top up 135. So my impress amount will be 200. So now I'm going to write the balance BD and then the impress amount inside my petty cash book. So this is the petty cash book. They already draw for us the table. So we use this. First, we start with 2020. On January 1, 2020, January 1, first thing I would like record is balance BD. My balance BD is 65. We write under the total receipt. After that, we need to top up. We top up by bank. We write here bank. And then the amount, just now I calculated the amount is 135. So my total now is 200. The date will be same date, so you don't need to write January 1 again. So we continue to read the question. January 3rd, purchase stationery for cash 24. Okay, so we record this stationery because since this is less than 200, so we can write in a petty cash book. So I go to my petty cash book. On the 3rd January, the detail here will be stationery. Your stationery will be 24 in a total paid. But remember something, any amount that you record in the total paid, you need to record another one time. It's either in a travel, postage or ledger account. Okay. The best place to write the 24 is stationery will go under postage and stationery. It's the analysis column. After that, next transaction. January 7. Paid traveling expenses. Traveling expenses 49. Can I record this in the petty cash book? Yes. Because it's less than 100. So I'll go to my petty cash book. On January 7, are right here. Travel. How much? 49. In travel, the best column to write is travel 49. After that, we continue. 14. Paid Razwan the amount outstanding of his account. So how much we owe the guy? We owe the guy 85. So we pay the guy 85. Is it less than 100? Yes. Since it's less than 100, so we can write in the petty cash book. We'll pay the cash from the petty cash book. So we go to the petty cash book. On the 14th, we write here Razwan. We write here Razwan. How much we owe Razwan? 85. So this 85, Razwan is my trade payable. So which column to best to write? Travel? Cannot. Postage also cannot. Ledger account. So all the trade payables we record under ledger account column. So 85, we write here 85. Continue rate. 19. Purchase goods on credit. Purchase goods on credit from Razwan. 200 less 10% trade discount. So this is on credit. Since it's on credit, we cannot record in our petty cash book. So we skip that particular transaction. We continue. On the 22nd, paid taxi fare 18. So taxi fare 18, we record in the petty cash book because it's less than 100. So we go to petty cash. I write 22nd. It is my taxi fare. The taxi fare was $18. And taxi fare, of course, will fall under travel. Then continue. On the 28th, return goods. Return goods to Razwan, which purchased on the 19th January. List price is 40. So this one also not related to petty cash. So I circle first. That one later, we'll see where to put, but cannot record in the petty cash because we didn't pay any money. Okay, next one is 29, paid postage for $11. So I go to petty cash, I write, the date is 29. Detail here will be postage, the amount is 11. And postage, we record under postage and stationery. Okay. We double check whether we record all the transaction or not. I go here. Yes, all the transaction taken care except 19 and 28, which not related to petty cash. So now I need to balance the petty cash. Petty cash. First step to balance out the petty cash is total up the total paid and analysis column. So draw a line here. We total up. For the total ledger, 85. Postage and stationery will be 35. Travel will be 67. And then total paid will be 187. After that, you can do a double line for analysis column. And now we go into balance up. Okay, how to balance up? We see total received and total paid. Which one bigger? Of course, total received will be bigger. So in a total paid, you leave one line and then draw a double line like this and go to total received, draw a double line like this. Then total up the total received, it will be 200. I write here 200. The same amount, 200, you write in the total paid also. Then you take the 200 minus with 187, we'll get a balance of 13. This is my balance CD, closing balance. The date will be last day of the month. Can I stop here? No, you are not allowed to stop at balance CD. This balance CD will brought forward for balance BD, brought down now. So I write here balance BD. My balance BD on February 1 is 30. That's it for your petty cash book. We have done the petty cash book. Okay, next one. We continue. Question number B. There's an extra information here. Amira's supplier Razwan. Amira's supplier Razwan. Maintain a full set accounting record. Okay. Prepare Amira's as it would be appear in the Razwan's ledger of Razwan. So now, okay, we must clarify this. Previously, the question number A, we are working for Amira. So this is Amira's book. We work for Amira. So we think from Amira's perception. But question number B, now they say Razwan. Because the question here say, prepare the account of Amira as it will appear in the ledger of Razwan. Ledger of Razwan means now we are working for Razwan. So you need to think from Razwan's point of view. So from the Razwan's point of view, Amira is your trade receivable or trade payable. From Razwan's point of view, Amira is my trade receivable. Trade receivable. Okay. We clearly understand this. The previous question, statement here. Here they say credit supplier. Why they are telling it is a credit supplier? Because Amira owe Razwan. So from the Amira's point of view, Razwan is trade credit supplier or trade payable. But now the question B, it is from the Razwan's point of view. From the Razwan's point of view, Amira is your trade receivable. So we're going to do the anything that related to Amira and Razwan. So I go check. Do you have any balances here? Yes. At first, the 85. So now, from the Razwan's point of view, Amira is trade receivable. So this 85, we record inside Amira's account, debit side. Why I write in a debit side? Because for Razwan, Amira is trade receivable. Trade receivable is my asset. So the asset balance will be in a debit side. Asset balance will be in a debit side. I go here, I write 2020, the balance in a debit side, 85. Write here, balance BD. The date will be January 1. Okay, after that, we see there's any transaction in between Razwan and Amira. Check from top to bottom. There's any transaction that related to Amira and Razwan. Yes, number 14. Number 14, paid Razwan the amount outstanding is account. So this particular line explaining from Amira's point of view. But now we need to do the account from the Razwan's point of view. So it means Razwan received the money from Amira. If Razwan received the money, we will plus the trade receivable Amira or we minus the trade receivable Amira. We will minus the trade receivable Amira. If we minus, this one will be in a credit side. So I go credit side, I write 2020. How much I pay? 85. What is the date? January 14. And then the detail here will be petty cash because the guy pay by petty cash. Okay, after that we continue. Any transaction that related to trade receivable Amira? Yes, on the 19. On the 19, from Amira's point of view, Amira say purchase goods on credit from Razwan. They purchase from Razwan. If now you are the Razwan, this is our sales. But they say 200 less trade discount of 10%. So if there is a trade discount, we don't record the trade discount. we will minus the trade discount, and then we take the net figure. The net figure will be record in our ledger. So can we calculate 200 times with 10%? 200 times with 10%, I will get 20. So 200 minus 20, I will get 180. So your sales will be 180. This is from Razwan's point of view. From Razwan's point of view, this is a sales 180. So I go to the Amira's account. In a debit side, I write here 180. The date will be January 19. The detail will be sales because this Razwan sell to Amira. After that, we go continue. There's any transaction that related to Razwan and Amira? Yes, one more, which is on the 28th. Return goods to Razwan, which had been purchased on 19, the list price. Okay, what is the meaning of list price? List price means the original price before minus trade discount, before minus the trade discount. So whenever we purchase or we sell, we record the amount after discount. We record the amount after discount. And then whenever the guy return this 40, they say list price means the original price. Okay, can I write 40? Cannot. Why cannot? Whenever you purchase, you record in the after discount price. Whenever you return also, you need to record after discount price. Okay, I calculate discount. 40 times with how much the discount on the 19th January? On the 19th January, the discount was 10%. So $40 times with 10%, I get 2. My discount is, supposed to be 4. Discount is 4. So 40 minus 4, I will get 36. So my return is 36. So I go to the Amira's account in the Razwan's book, will be in a credit side because it is a sales return, it will reduce the trade receivable. So on the 28th, I write here sales return is 36. Okay, any other transaction for Amira's account in the Razwan's book? No. So now we will balance up. How to balance up? You check debit, total debit and total credit. Which one bigger? I feel debit bigger. So draw a line like this. Total of the debit, I get 265. Then go credit side, write the same amount, 265. You take the 265 minus 36 minus 85. You will get 144. This 144 on the last day of the month will become my balance CD. This balance CD will become my balance BD on the following day. Balance BD on February 1. Okay, we are done with this. Question B, we continue. Next one. On 2nd February 2020, Amira paid the balance due to Razwan. So Amira paid. She deducted the cash discount of 2%. Okay. Just now, I say credit discount, you no need to record in any accounts book. But this is the cash discount. Cash discount, do you need to record? Yes. You need to record in your ledger account. Your trade discount, no need to record in ledger. In the ledger. Okay. Trade discount, no need to record. We straight away minus. We take the net figure and write in our ledger. We no need to record trade discount. But cash discount. Do you need to record the cash discount? Yes. You need to record in your ledger. So we read the question. What the question wants. Complete the following table by tick the correct column to show how Razwan should record in the cash discount. Okay, for Razwan, Razwan is the buyer or seller. Razwan is your seller. If the Razwan seller, seller will give the discount or will receive the discount. Seller will give. Or another word, we will call that, we allow discount. Okay, now we think from the Razwan's point of view. Where an account is has no entry, tick no entry. Okay, I can do. Amira. Amira is my Razwan's trade receivable. Whenever you give or you allow a discount, your trade receivable will increase or trade receivable will decrease. Your trade receivable will decrease. Trade receivable is your asset. Asset decrease means we record in the credit side. And also discount allowed. Discount allowed is your expenses. Expenses increase. This is your expenses. Expenses increase means we put in the debit side. Sorry. Debit side. You need to tick. And then discount received. Oh, this is not a discount received. Okay. The discount received, we don't record because now the transaction here, the cash discount here is discount allowed, not discount received. So discount received, we will put in a no entry. Okay. Next question. Question D. Amira usually pay Razwan by cash and check. Okay. Required. State two other methods which Amira could use to pay Razwan from a bank account. Okay. From the bank account, we can pay by check, but the question asking other than check. Other than check, maybe we can use our direct debit. Direct debit facility. Or what you can do, you can pay by credit card. You can use a credit card or you can use a debit card. Okay, I give you extra one. Maybe you can add one. You can do a online payment. Do an online payment. So these are the other than we pay check using bank money. Bank money. Okay, that's it. Question number one. We are done with the question number one for IGCSC accounting February March paper 2020. Question number one. See you tomorrow for question number two. Thank you. Love accounts. Accounts will love you back.